Let's look at yet another type of data we'd like to bring in our report. In this example, we would like to bring in the pH from our event frame attribute. And what we'd like is a list of all of the data points. So if you remember our existing report, here I have our compliance report open. We've brought in the pH as a trend. We've brought in the pH as a summary table. Now I'd like a table that includes a list of all of the data points that are included in this trend. And in this video, we're going to show how to do that with the compressed data and iterators. And then in the next video, we're going to show how to report on only certain values that are above a certain value. Let's go ahead and start by going into the data template. And we're going to work on the mixing unit. And we already have a journal action for the pH. And it brings in trend and summary. So let's go ahead and open that existing journal action. We're going to use the existing action parameter, which links to the event frame attribute for the pH. But we're going to add another result definition. In this case, I'm going to add one called compressed values. This is going to pull in the values actually from the PyData archive. My data source is from the action parameter, the pH. And that's actually all I need to do. So let me click OK. Now I've already chosen an event frame, obviously, to get this example report here on the right. And this was batch ID 2512. So let me go ahead and view refresh to update the data journal. Let's go ahead and take a look at what the journal looks like now that we've added this section here. In fact, I forgot to add a name to it. So I'm going to call this pH compressed and refresh again. This is at the unit batch level, so I'm going to open up my batch journal, go into unit batch journals. To remind you, the first two here are for mixing units. So if I go in either of these, I'll check my journal events. The first journal event, or the only journal event actually, is for the pH here, which corresponds to this over here on the left. And if I check the terminal states, journal entries, and results, there's three different results. The first result here is the pH trend. The second result is the pH summary. And the third result is the new one that we just added, which is pH compressed. We take a look at the columns, and these are the definitions. The first column is the value, and this is inside of our journal. And it has a property of 22,000. So I want you to remember that value, 22,000. The next is the UTC time. And that has a property column of 100. So when we bring these into our report, we're going to make sure we find those. So if we go into the events, these are each our individual events of our compressed data. If I open up one of them, I can see here a value of 100. This is the time in UTC. And then here's the property descriptor 22,000. This is the actual value. Okay. So this is the section that we need to bring into our report. So now that we've got the data in the journal, let's go ahead and work in the format template. We're going to go under our entry that corresponds to our mixing unit. And under our pH summary data, which is this table here, I want a table with all of the compressed data. So first, let me go ahead and say insert text. And I'm going to say pH compressed data. And then let me add a table. Our table is going to have two rows. The first row is going to be the headers. The second row is going to be the values, and then we're going to iterate on that row. We're going to have two columns, timestamp and value. So for the first row here in the first column, I'm going to insert text that says timestamp. And in the second column, I'm going to insert text that says value. Or actually, we'll just say pH. The second row needs to be iterated on, and it's going to iterate through all of these properties. So if I drag this over to my table row expressions in my iterator, I'm going to bring over properties. And then within my table data, the first one I have is time, so it's UTC time. And remember, that was property descriptor 100. And my next one is going to be the value. So I'm going to insert data. And the source on that is property descriptor 22,000. Let me go ahead and go back to the report. And we'll do a view refresh and see what this looks like. If I go into my unit information, there's my pH trend, my values, and then here's the table. Now on tables, I forgot, I always like to add borders. Let's go do border width 2, view, refresh. And there's all my pH values. And this actually does make sense. The first value is a value of 8. Here's the value of 8. Here's the value of 8.24. 8.24. So this is the same data that's in the trend. Now that we've looked at how to bring compressed data into a table using iterators, let's show how we can place some filters onto which data is reported based on the value, how to indicate values at different levels by adding colors, and also how to report on digital states. This will all be in the next video.